We're here in the University of Birmingham's Great Hall. The students sitting in our hall are about to join the thousands of alumni who have passed through our university since it first admitted students. Degree congregations at the University of Birmingham date back to 1901 and are held here in the Great Hall, right at the heart of our Edgbaston campus. Attended by nearly 30,000 graduates and guests each year, these events are the highlight of the university calendar and represent for many students the conclusion of their studies at Birmingham. Originally built as a cathedral to learning, the Great Hall never fails to impress our students. The building is Grade 2 listed, and it's really the details that make the space so special. It features a trompe l'oeil domed ceiling located above its formal marble entrance. The entrance is bordered by archways that are designed to draw the eye toward the centre of the room.
Thank you.
audience is a mixture of graduands, seated in the back of the room, and their friends and families, seated near the stage. During the ceremony, the graduands will make their way up to the stage, accept their scroll, and be applauded by their families and fellow students. In the sea of formal robes in the ceremony, attendees may spot black gowns, red and green gowns, and possibly some other eye-catching colours. The black robes are worn by those graduating with their bachelor's and master's. Green and red robes are for those picking up a PhD. The music you can hear is being performed by our very own student musicians. They often perform versions of modern pop hits or songs with a Birmingham connection. So if you're thinking, that sounds a little like Duran Duran, you might be onto something. You'll be hearing more from the student musicians towards the end of the ceremony. Thank you. Soon, our ceremony will begin. There's a degree of pomp and circumstance to the day that echoes back through the years. These rituals connect our graduands today to students from the very first universities formed in the 13th century. Who will sit on stage throughout the ceremony, usually senior academics at the university, are led into the Great Hall by two mace bearers. There is a mace bearer at the front of the line and one at the back. The latter is called the Esquire Bedell. Both carry large silver maces that they put down on stage. This is a ceremonial kickoff to the day. The mace bearers are usually staff members from the university who have volunteered to take part. A senior member of the university, such as the Chancellor or a Provost, will be the last to take their place. They'll stand before the attendees and declare the congregation open.
I declare the congregation open.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Birmingham. I'm Adam Tickell. I'm the University Vice Chancellor, and it's a real pleasure to welcome you all here to this amazing celebration this morning. It's a particular pleasure to have so many of the graduands and your friends and your family and your supporters here in the Great Hall, watching us elsewhere in the university and around the world. Dedication, resilience, growth, achievement, and friendship. These are just some of the words that I'm sure would have characterized your time here at the University of Birmingham. But there'll have been some apprehension, some setbacks, some problems, some doubt, and along the way, some failure. These are integral to everybody's lives and everybody's journey. But we're here today to recognize and to celebrate the completion of your journey to your degree. To get to this moment, you'll have spent time exploring new ideas and experiencing the thrill of intellectual discovery. You'll have had coffee-filled debates with your fellow students during late-night study sessions and tackled seemingly insurmountable problems and overcome them. You'll have learnt about perseverance, about balancing work and play, and about the values of friendship and community. All of these are lessons that you'll carry with you long after you leave the hall. But universities, of course, are more than just centres of learning. We're melting pots of cultures, of ideas, of beliefs, of languages, and of customs. Your time in Birmingham will have provided fertile ground for meaningful and formative relationships. You'll have forged friendships during shared experiences at social events, in classrooms, and in practice. Treasure these friendships. They will be as important as anything else you've learned here at Birmingham. They're the foundation for your future support network, and they'll provide you with emotional sustenance and even career advice. These are people who'll stand alongside you when times are difficult and will celebrate as you achieve things in the future. As I say, you've made relationships which will last you a lifetime. And I hope as you look back on your time with us, you'll feel a huge sense of pride. Today is an important step in your journey, a moment to celebrate your tenacity, your determination, and your drive. Let's also take a moment to acknowledge everyone who's played a part in getting you here today. Behind me are just some of the staff who've encouraged your intellectual curiosity, who've given you such great training and inspired you to question and explore. And you'll also be supported by tutors and student support teams. So let's give a big round of applause to everyone who's helped you behind me today. But I hope the staff will forgive me, because I think in front of me and watching online are people who are more important, your families, your friends, and your supporters, who are genuinely brimming with pride for everything that you've achieved. You'll all have those people who have faith in you, people who support you and show you kindness, and without whom you wouldn't be here. So graduands particularly, let's give a huge round of applause to everybody who's made today possible. Do you know what? I can hear the family and friends clapping themselves, but I can't hear the graduands giving a cheer to their people who've got them. So try again. That's better, thank you. Today, you'll be leaving your education behind. Don't lose the curiosity you've nurtured during your studies, and for you particularly, this will be important. Listen to the voices in your head that say, go on, let's have a look, see what's out there. Seek out new knowledge, because this will lead you in the direction of your best of adventures. Soon you'll be joining me up on the stage and I will formally admit you to your degree. The moment when your name is read out, that's the moment of your graduation. And family and friends, that's your cue to make a lot of noise. So as you come up, do be careful on the steps, particularly if you're wearing heels, be careful as you come down. We've got a great array of laps for you to fall into, but I'm sure they won't mind if you don't manage that. Give a big smile for the cameras and don't forget to save your moment. Thank you very much.
Good morning. I am Professor Kate Thomas and I'm the Dean of Birmingham Medical School. Vice-Chancellor and Principal, to you and to the University, I present the names of these graduands as listed in my programme, proved worthy to be admitted to their respective degrees.
University of Birmingham, it's my pleasure to admit those people listed in the programme for the degrees to which they presented.
College of Medical and Dental Sciences, Institute of Clinical Sciences, Master of Science, Clinical Neuropsychiatry, Frank Beckhamson. George Anroj Wakuru. Physician Associate Studies, Daniel Ian Woosie. Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, Medicine, Amira Abdullahi. Anita Nagaraja Adiga. Werda Afzal. Aina Agarwal. Fabia Ahmed. Ifsa Ahmed. Nosheen Ahmed. Rayan Ahmed. Shadman Ahmed. Mohammed Salim Ahmed. Amar Isan. Nimra Isan. Yusra Al-Haji. Anisa Ali. Isha Turazia Ali. Asghar Ali Shah. Lucy Allen. Nana Akuza Pinangmang Amankwa. Sorry. Okay. Of course you can.
It's Nana Akosiapenamai Amankwa.
I did have a West African dialect coach, but I had a problem with your name. Thank you for doing that. Rashid Mohammed Amin. Sharon Obiageli Adeya Adeze Amono Amukwa Mara. Jyotsna Anand. Jennifer Ruth Anderson. Isabel Andrews. Danielle Nana Aya Oye Aduba Ankra Anoba. Ariba Rumi Ansari. Fatima Arman. Daniel Arshad. Aminta Wahida Arshad. Natasha Elizabeth Ashbridge. Ashmitha Ashok Kumar. Saleha Ashraf. Aisha Fahin Ashraf. Shruti Subhash Atade. Ao Matthew Chun. Ibanano Akaye.
It's Ibinabo Ayuka.
Mohammed Maz Azam. Nishathika Balasubramanian. Rebecca Tandiway, Lydia Damilola Barak. Fatimata Barry. Catherine Barry. Cecily Harriet Basil. Olivia Bates. Serene Jasmine Rihanna Batson Patel. Amar Bagania. Kumail Muhammad Ali Balu. Saloni Bhattacharya. Gakiran Bogle. Lucy Elizabeth Bidwell. Marina Grace Billings. Alex Frank Bird. Gemma Sacia Black. Brianna Blackborough. Benedicta Suoma Buama. Kasper Bonietsky. Garanpreet Singh Bora. Amy Elizabeth Booth. Megan Louise Botley. Rosie Charlotte Bolton. Joelson Brady. Thomas Joshua Brown. Alexander Brown. Caitlin Jane Bryant. Anushka Devi Bucktower. Rosemary Burke. Elisa Nicole Burke. Millie Kate Burns. Natalie Veronique Burt. Yasmin Mohammed Omar Kabdi. Robin Campbell. Emma Campbell-John. Kramer Chow. Sachin Chambers. Izad Atta Hussein Chowdhury. Talha Chowdhury. Gia Cherian. Amrit Singh Chirimar. Vaishali Ashwin Kumar Chudasama. Shannon Clark. Alice Sarah Code. Sophie Coe. Eleanor Sarah Cole. Alicia Cooper. Eden Cooper. Diana Joanna Constantin. Emily Coulson. Lucy Elizabeth Pearl Crossland. Catherine Cubitt. Alfred George Cudderford. Ashling Cullinan Peterson. Alice Elizabeth Curzon. Charlotte Daly. Emma Natalie Aileen Daly. Lucy Florence Lily Davis. Ikra Darwood. Maya Cariad De Silva Morgan. Libania Martina Diaz. India Naomi Lacey Dickinson. Benjamin Jacob Dimbleby. Kayla Dixon. Mervey Fotso Dijala. Jacob Oliver Doody. Jasmine Down. Charlotte Elizabeth Druitt. Camille Susanna Dubuisson. Zuhaib Ishan. Shida Eklasi.
Graduates, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just partly to apologise to Kate, who has the most difficult job of anybody, which is reading out such a broad range of names. And the when I got married, I got my name wrong. So as I said at the beginning, my name is Adam Tickell. And the registrar read out, said, repeat after me, I, Adam Thomas Tickell. And I said, I, Adam Thomas Tickell. So anybody who gets, if we do get your name wrong, apologies, but it happens to the best of us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mariam El Ghadi. Maya Mohammed Imaladin Ibrahim El Hariri. Henry Ashton Elsie. Natasha Emery. Nathan Davin Farmer. Sawat Naeem Farooqi. Charles Fernando. Nicole Lauren Farrow. Alice Laura Field. Serena Fleming. Jordan Alex Foden Aris. Padma Anastasia Maryarman Fordham. Helen Elizabeth Fraser. George Benjamin Freer. James French. Ritu Srinivas Garda. Leah Gelder. Malika Dilara Gerrits. Anka Aletha Gavan Piteous. Matthew David James Gibson. Joanna Jinai. Vivine Hodiva Grant. Eleanor Gray. Emma Claire Green. Keslin Greenwood. Isabel Rebecca Marina Greenwood. Benjamin Greer. Julian Nicholas Gregg. Daniel Grogan. Francesca Louise Groom. Duleni Nemaya Gunaratne. Roland Jemfi. Kasim Zakaria Haider. Natasha Charlotte Hall. Catherine Rosie Hulse. Fiona Alexandra Hamilton. Bissamul Haque. Omar Hack, Dinda Orlia Hermanto, Kaylee Anjali Harilal, Phoebe Claire Hartop, Taha Hassan, Saida Liaba Hassan, M. Shiabul Hassan, Umar Yusuf Hatia, Chloe Hayes, Callum Joseph McRobbie Henry, Darcy Caitlin Hay, Sarah Elizabeth Hickson, Kelly Lee Higgins, Alexandra Lee Heine, Sarah Hogben, Zachariah Ahmed Hogsaid, Keelan Houston, Molly Claire Hughes, Anusha Hundal, Isla Jabeen Hussain, Neha Mariam Hussain, Maymuna Tabassum Hussain, Seljan Itchley, Issa Idris, Sinzia Zaina Iftikhar, Abare Ikwenusi, Hamna Iqbal, Ayman Athar Ishak, Olive Jackson, Rhea Sarah Jacob, Sam Jacobs, Gursirat Jagra, Shamaya Jaben Ali, Nilesh Jaipal, Aman Zahir Jamal, Holly James. Kyuhyuk Kelvin Jang. Sophie Louisa Jarrett. Zach Jefferson Pillai. Alexander Dewey Peter Jones. Evelyn E. Ann Jose. Nikita Rose Joseph. Anushri Joshi. Alicia Kayla. Ashwin Kalyana. Jason Philip Canacherel. Harjeevan Singh Kang. Suniva Kanasaka. Kumil Kansi. Amrit Kaur. Tristan John Kavalek. Aisha Kazi. Elodie Rose Octavia Kenyon Slaney. Simon Keogh. Thomas Edward Kerfoot. Mamoon Khan. Nayab Khan. Seth Khan. Shami Kanom. Amina Kanum. Min Soo Kim. Victor Judah Mbugwa Kamani. Chloe Beryl Knight. Tamlin Lara Knight. Anna Josephine Christopic. Mayuri Zita Kuha Kumaran. Devya Kumarisan. Alex Kurowski Ford. Avantika Kiran. Lubna Latif. Tuba Rafiq. Bachelor of Science, Medical Studies. Charlie Whelan. Please will all the MBCHB graduates stand to join me in reciting the Declaration for University of Birmingham Health Professions based on the GMC's duties of a doctor. In accepting my degree today, I recognise that I embark upon a career involving care of patients, Well done, you may sit down. It gives me great pleasure now to ask Saloni Bhattacharya to come to give a short speech on behalf of the graduating cohort.
Good morning, and welcome, esteemed guests, fellow graduates, and faculty. My name is Saloni Bhattacharya, and it is a great honor for me to address you all today to celebrate the graduation of my medicine cohort, class of 2024. I would like to begin by congratulating my fellow graduates. It is a testament of your hard work, dedication, and resilience that you are here today. Each of you have your own story and will have had your own challenges to get to this stage, on top of the academic pressures of this course, of course. This moment was years in the making. There were sleepless nights, hours of work, and cancelled plans. You sacrificed time away from your family, friends, and hobbies. Today, your effort is seen and acknowledged. We are all so proud of your incredible achievement. Please can we get a massive round of applause for your brand new doctors here today. I would like to now take this time to reminisce and reflect on our experiences over the last 5 years of our medical school. Medicine is a unique course. From the beginning, we are held responsible for patient safety, and we must conduct ourselves in a professional manner. We had to learn immense amounts of content during our preclinical years, where we slowly built a foundation of knowledge, an almost new language of sorts. This learning then continues into the clinical years, where we gain practical skills, witness ward rounds, surgeries, and even crash calls. Often, these experiences can be unfathomable to others, but is immensely profound for us. We then translate this knowledge to our patients in simpler terms to be accessible and empower our patients to learn about their health. In a way, we demonstrate another facet of the term doctor, deriving from the Latin to teach. We are taught, we teach ourselves, and then we teach others. Dear colleagues, I wonder if you recognize how much you have grown throughout the years. Surpassing exams that were harder every single year, you have culminated a large repertoire of skills and knowledge. Perhaps there were days where you only felt useful pulling back the curtain on the wards. I know I was there. Maybe you've developed a very strong dependence on caffeine. But I want to reassure you that you deserve to be here today. When I opened my final results, there were no big letters screaming, "You're a doctor now." But it was when I called my parents, when my mum started crying, and then I did too, that it slowly began to sink in. That moment was so much bigger than me. Maybe, like me, you will be the first doctor in the family, and you will have had access to education that our ancestors maybe did not have. You all have your own story, but I hope you would agree that we would not be here today without the support of our loved ones, friends, and family. As a cohort, we have had an unprecedented year. Not only with the added challenge of the global pandemic, we face the new changes to the UK Foundation programme. This has been a cause of distress to many. I recognize my words may offer little consolation, however, I would like to say this. Any department, any hospital, and any place will be lucky to have you. I remain awed by our sense of community and the way we always try to support one another and make things better. Despite our fears and our very valid concerns, I have witnessed how a kind junior doctor can take a medical student under their wing and transform their day into one that was passive, into one that was full of learning and growth. I have faith we will be such doctors in the future. Therefore, I would like to encourage us to be kind to one another, but also especially to ourselves. So I want to say this, believe in yourselves. You had the tenacity, the resilience, and the dedication to complete this challenging course. It is my sincerest hope for us to support one another, work towards a healthy working environment, and enjoy practicing medicine in the years to come. As the speech is coming to an end, I would now like to take this time to say thanks to the many people involved in our successful degree completion. First and foremost, I would like to send my thanks and prayers to my God. Thank you for listening to my prayers, and please may you look after all of us. As part of the Hindu religious text, the Bhagavad Gita, I would like to recite this quote to you. Tasmat ashakta shattam karyam karma samachara ashakto hyacharan karma param apnoti purusha. By striving to serve the welfare of the world, one attains the supreme goal of life. My thanks to the medicine faculty. Many thanks for putting in hours of work, time, and effort to support us throughout our degree. It is the joint effort from the administration team, lecturers, professors, and clinical teaching fellows that we were able to learn and progress throughout the years. On behalf of our cohort, I would like to thank all of you for your contribution to our success. A round of applause, please. I would also like to thank Professor Thomas. Professor Thomas, I've had the pleasure of being able to work with you during my time as a Year 3 representative, and I'm sure all the students would agree when I say this. You truly care about our students as individuals. We are incredibly fortunate and lucky to have a dean who has been a constant role model and parental figure to us. Many a time have we emailed you, I know I certainly have, and you have supported us individually. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts for being there for us since the beginning of our journey. A big thank you and round of applause for Professor Thomas, please. To my friends, I'm incredibly fortunate to say there are too many to list in this moment of time. It was these friendships that have made university some of the best years of my life. From friends made in first year up to those made in final year, I will treasure every single one. I will cherish those memories where I felt welcome, included, and joyful the most. So even if we had a brief conversation, please do keep in touch. I will treasure these memories forever. Last, but certainly not least, I must convey my biggest thanks and gratitude to my parents, Shubesh and Devjani Bhattacharya. The extent of your sacrifice, dedication, and support is simply too difficult to summarize in a few words. More than 20 years ago, you traveled from India to the UK to selflessly overcome generational differences to provide me with education, opportunities, and open doors that were never available to you. You faced challenges of leaving your family and familiarity behind and experienced periods of even isolation and discrimination. My father and my friend, who worked tirelessly and has never once complained, is one of the smartest people I know. My mother, who has sacrificed more than I could ever verbalize, has been my support system from day one and has dedicated her life to me. This achievement is just as much yours as it is mine. It is an honor to be your legacy. Thank you forever for your love and support. Thank you everyone for listening to me today. Once again, a massive congratulations to your new doctors and graduates. We did it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Salone. I think we can all safely say that was a great speech. So I think she deserves another round of applause. And please keep clapping. Congratulations to all of you, graduates, and your relatives, your parents, your friends. So keep clapping. You are now graduates of the University of Birmingham and doctors. I can see, trust me, I think we've heard, the front of the room is incredibly proud of you. It really is. I've actually started to play a game of trying to pair the student with the parents. Some of you make it easier than others. My name is Neil Hanley. I'm Pro Vice Chancellor, head of the College of Medical Dental Sciences. It's a great, great privilege to be at your graduation, to participate, and in particular, to close out this ceremony with a few words. I'm not going to speak for too long, but there are a couple of topics that I would like to touch on before the ceremony is closed here in our great hall, which I'm sure you'll all agree is a truly remarkable, wonderful setting. And before, I hope, you go off and celebrate long and hard. I have written into the evening. That might require you to pace yourself a little. But make the most of it, because this is a day you'll remember for the rest of your lives. They are genuinely memories for life. So alongside my day job here in the university, like you all now, I am a medical doctor. I'm an endocrinologist, hormones. I think it's fair to say it's an interesting time. Most of you are about to enter the NHS workforce. We've had backlogs, pressures, strikes, a lot of recent political attention with the election. The latest language is that the NHS is broken. I think we have to be slightly careful about how we use language, mindful of how it's picked up by public patients. But for sure, one thing is true, and that is we are not broken. You are now fully fledged members of a truly tremendous, important profession. A profession that is trusted, looked up to, and hugely valued in society. People place their health and well-being in your hands as doctors. And now all of a sudden it's for real. Trust me. I can remember those days. You're no longer a student. You've got tremendously important jobs to do. So what determines whether you will be good at those jobs? Well, the knowledge you have acquired over the last few years is clearly pivotally important. And you really have acquired that knowledge In a university that is on the up, a university that is known around the world, a university that is increasingly a global player. If you think back a moment to what you were like when you started the course and who you are now, you will see a very different person. For most of you, no longer a school leaver, you're a mature, confident person ready for the workplace. I'm confident your knowledge is strong. Congratulations on that. The trick, as we've touched on earlier today, is to keep it strong. Never stop learning. Never lose that intellectual curiosity that is one of the defining characteristics we as a university set for all of our students. Please stay curious. Keep that inquiring mind. Accumulate ever more knowledge and wisdom in your medical careers. It is a science, not an art. The knowledge aspect isn't actually my main point. My main point's far simpler than that. You are about to enter workplaces where something is far more important than your knowledge. You're about to be centre stage on something that's super, super privileged. As doctors, you will meet people when they're at their most vulnerable, at their most scared. They may even come across as angry. But this is when they need you most, as part of crucially important teams. And I ask that you never forget one thing for the rest of your careers. Smile. Be kind. You can't overestimate what an important part of your role that is. There will be times you're tired, you're fed up, you're hungry, you're too busy, you've been on call for too long, you're preoccupied by your own problems. Did you see how easily that sort of tripped off the tongue? Please smile. It's one of the most fundamental aspects of being a proper, proper doctor. And encourage all of those around you to follow suit. The second and final topic on which I want to close returns to what I've just said about our university. You're now part of our history. You will forever be one of our graduates. We are very, very proud of you. Many of you will go on to achieve tremendous things beyond your direct clinical roles. Not just doctors, but amongst you will be pioneers, innovators, movers and shakers of the next generation. I'm actually going to go off piste for a moment and call out something very special about Birmingham. Some of our most inspiring students. To those in the front, you may not know this, but Birmingham is not just a tremendous academic university. We are one of the country's leading destinations for sport. We look forward to the Olympics. One third of the women's GB hockey squad, Olympic champions in 2016, are alumni of the University of Birmingham. We truly excel, not just at hockey, but at netball, rugby, athletics, swimming. Ollie Morgan, second year in sports science, has just left for Paris for the Olympics, 100 meter backstroke, possibly the medley as well. Within our medical cohort, just finished third year on our graduate entry program, we have what it means to be a Birmingham dual career student athlete. Katie Moll has just received her first full GB rowing vest at the recent World Championships as part of the development program for the Los Angeles Olympics in 2028. That is a University of Birmingham student living and breathing what it means to be dual career, international athlete, top class scholar, top class university. Back on piste, you are now our alumni. What do we ask of you? It's very, very simple, and we've touched on it as well earlier this morning. Please stay in touch. It means a lot to us. Yes, as you go out into the world, become successful, of course we would like to see you as our future philanthropic benefactors, helping the next generation, such as the support fund that we set up this year to counter the cost of living challenges increasingly faced by some of our medical students. Relatively small sums, but small sums that make a massive difference. I'm actually talking about something bigger. I meet with lots of our medical alumni. They care about the place, it's full of their memories, and they make tremendous advocates for us around the world, assisting future student recruitment, acting as mentors, and most certainly helping me as head of college, helping our courses, offering advice. So please do sign up with our development and alumni relations team. Please stay in touch. Our careers service is still there for you. I've recently had the pleasure, I know I don't look it, but I've recently had the pleasure of 30 years reunion from my university of Edinburgh. Our alumni relations team run events for recent graduates so you can connect up around the world, wherever you end up. We will always be pleased to see you. So that's me. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you for listening. Not quite finished. Most of all, and this is why, congratulations on your achievements and good luck as you go forward as doctors. So before I hand back to our Vice Chancellor to close the ceremony, I have one final thing. It's not a request, it's an order. Go and celebrate. Celebrate hard and celebrate like you mean it. We are incredibly proud of you. Thank you very much.
I declare the congregation closed.
And with those words, our new graduates leave the Great Hall. The ceremony that completes the university journey for hundreds of Birmingham alumni has come to an end. This is a powerful moment for our graduates, representing the culmination of years of dedicated study, the education, connections, and friendships they have made at Birmingham will last a lifetime. And with Birmingham ranking as the university most targeted by top graduate employers in 2024, there's never been a more exciting time to be a Birmingham graduate. A final bit of tradition to close the ceremony. The maces are collected from the stage, and the mace bearers lead the procession of staff and new graduates out of the Great Hall. Our new alumni are off to celebrate the rest of their day with their friends and families.